correct?
Correct, if I may tell you why.
Okay.
Because as soon as we would go in to see my daughter, guess who else would know about it? The general public.
I understand. But it is true that there was no other visit at the video visitation center or otherwise arranged at the Orange County Jail after August 14th of 2008. Accurate?
That's accurate. May I also add to that?
Okay.
Because then again, it would be released to all media outlets and things like that. That's okay. The reason why we didn't go back and see my daughter.
Well, when you testified at the hearing on July 29th of 2008, your testimony was an effort to prevent that public release so that you could have private visits with your daughter.
Absolutely, yes.
And that was a motion that was filed by her lawyer, correct?
Yes, ma'am. I can't file them.
I understand that. And you testified as a result of a hearing that her lawyer acquired from Judge Strickland's assistant.
Yes, ma'am. I'll agree with you.
Right. Do you recall your testimony at that hearing was that you and your wife and perhaps your son would like to speak to your daughter?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Regardless of whatever communication you were having with law enforcement as that investigation progressed, you and your wife and your son wanted to independently have private conversations with your daughter while she was in jail?
Yes, ma'am. I wanted to talk to my daughter.
And you asked Mr. Baez to facilitate that by having the court order that conversations at the jail between you and your daughter, your wife and your daughter, your son and your daughter would be private.
I guess that's a fair statement.
Yeah, you asked for court intervention through Mr. Baez.
Well, the only way it can be done, ma'am, is through a motion, through the court. I understand that. I understand the legalities of that, yes.
All right. Do you recall your testimony that among the reasons why you wanted to have these private visits with your daughter was, first of all, to see if your daughter was okay and to make her smile? Do you remember that testimony?
I probably did that, yes, probably. I'm sure I did, because I'm sure you have the stuff on tape.
And that you wanted to ask her little things that would assist you or your wife or your son in locating Kaylee Anthony.
Yes, ma'am. Anything I could do to get my granddaughter back. Yes, ma'am.
So the family had a goal at that point that coincided with the goal of law enforcement to find Kaylee Marie Anthony. Correct?
I've said this many, many times, yes, and I'll agree with you to a point. But you know, ma'am, I would have sold my soul to the devil to get my granddaughter back.
So if law enforcement at that point had concluded that this was a domestic disturbance, squabble, fight between Casey Anthony and her mother, and that they weren't going to intervene, the family, you, your wife, and your son, would continue in any way possible, with or without the involvement of law enforcement, to find Kaylee Marie Anthony.
Well, you're wrong in that point.
If the police said, we're hands off, you all figure this family problem out on your own, you would have closed up shop?
Oh, no, ma'am.
You would have continued your independent efforts, whether that be by media appearances or a hotline or a command center, to find Kaylee Marie Anthony.
Anything I could have done to brought my granddaughter home, I would have done, and I would still do.
And you
still do.
And the point being that you would have done that independent of law enforcement.
If they weren't going to help, I would have found other means to get help, and I did that. I did that through Kid Finders Network, and other organizations are out there to assist.
Right.
Other families that were there to assist us, ma'am.
Right.
I don't know why you're going in this direction, because right
Your
now,
Honor, I'm going
I
to object
I
to
could
Mr.
Change,
Anthony challenging
change places
me,
with me.
Mr. rather than answering Anthony, questions.
I will challenge you.
Mr. Anthony, just listen to the question, sir.
Well, you know, sir, if I may not ask you for a second. Sir, this is a very emotional time, sir.
Mr. Anthony, I understand that, but listen to the questions and only answer the questions that are asked of you, sir. I know it's emotional. Take your time. Need a recess, sir.
No, sir, I'm fine. I just want to get this over with, sir.
Okay. All right. Next question. Thank question, please.
Yes, sir. In your direct testimony, you reference the contact that you did have with law enforcement, and you also testified about statements, some given with your knowledge and another recorded surreptitiously, that you gave to law enforcement. Do you recall that?
Yes.
May I approach the witness?
You may.
I will put the evidence items in front of you. I'll start with July 24th.
What are the exhibit numbers?
One is introduced, one isn't.
Okay, the one that's not introduced, have it marked for identification so the record will be abundantly clear as to what's being shown to the jury. By exhibit numbers.
Right. Exhibit number two is the tape transcript of July 24th, 2008. Exhibit F for identification is the interview with George Anthony and Scott Boland. I guess we don't have the surreptitious recording yet, the transcript of it.
Yes, we do. I have to ask.
May we have a moment?
You may.
Do you recall on July 24th, 2008, your expressing to Yuri Melich, a detective with the Orange County Sheriff's Office, that you understand that the police cannot go talk to Casey Anthony without her attorney present?
Yes, that only makes sense.
Do you recall conversations prior to July 24th of 2008 with Yuri Melich or John Allen, wherein you, your wife in your presence, or your son in your presence, expressed a desire for the Orange County Sheriff's Office to go speak to your daughter?
I'm sure I did.
And do you recall their reply to you being, "We can't talk to her, she has a lawyer"?
I'm sure that part of the conversation came up. I'm sure it did.
Right. Do you recall on July 24th of 2008, Yuri Melich indicating to you that he cannot solicit anything from your daughter, that he cannot put himself in that position?
I don't remember that conversation.
If I may approach the witness, Your Honor, or actually ask the witness to refer to, I believe it's 2, which is the July 24th interview. Do you have that? If Mr. Anthony will turn to page 67. If you read lines 1 through 9 to yourself and tell me if that refreshes your recollection about a conversation that Yuri Melich of the Orange County Sheriff's Office had with you on that date. Does that refresh your recollection?
Yes, reading it over does. Sure.
Right. Did Yuri Melich tell you that he did not want to put himself in that position?
Sure, and I agreed with him.
When you spoke with Scott Bolin, we talked about Scott, or you talked about Scott Bolin during your direct examination. That is the other reference, the lettered exhibit for identification that is in front of you.
Are you talking about the other transcript to my right?
I am, sir. The one that starts out at the top that says transcript of taped interview of George Anthony. And then it says conducted by Detective Edwards, but at the bottom references Scott Bolin. Do you recall, do you have that available? If you could turn to page 76.
I have nothing here about, I'm sorry, it's so Detective Edwards, I'm sorry. What page again, please?
76. Do you recall testifying about this statement during your direct examination?
About the one about Scott Bowling stating about the problem that we're having right now is a problem of not communication with you or your wife or your son?
Right, lines 12 through 16.
Sure.
Do you recall Scott Bowling, or did Scott Bowling explain that process to you where she is represented, we don't have access to her, legitimately so?
Sure, it's even printed right here.
You remember him expressing an understanding of the process that even though they feel that that's a communication problem that's hampering things, that they understand their access is legitimately restricted.
Yes, I understand that.
And that was expressed to you?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yes. If you can turn to page 85, lines 17 through 24.
What numbers again, please?
17 through 24 on page 85. Do you see the?
Yes, I'm reading it right now.
Okay. Did you express to the Orange County Sheriff's Office and the Federal Bureau of Investigation that you wanted to be able to talk to your daughter?
Yes, ma'am.
that if you couldn't get information out of her, you believed that your wife or son could?
Yes, ma'am.